Sorry about that. Unloading corn, and then I'll be able to update my course play. For my trucks, so I can just focus on the grain cart. I'm gonna actually set my cruise control down to like 45. Now we're recording. This is quite the load, really. Actually, like 43 miles an hour is going to be my cruise control. Anything over that, I think course play has a hard time really handling. But hopefully this makes my life a little bit easier. Doesn't cause too much troubles. first load of corn going in. A little bit heavier than sunflower. Nice thing with course play is it will close the tarps automatically. So I'll just use my cruise control again, so I don't go over like 45 or anything like that. Hopefully this does the job, otherwise I don't know what I'm gonna do with all this corn that needs to come out of here. Hopefully the double trailers isn't an issue unloading. But I guess we'll see. Once we get the course actually made and saved, then we can adjust and tweak it and stuff like that. The only downside is you pretty much have to make a course like this for each field. So I only use it if I'm, in a big field like this. Otherwise, I think it's kind of a waste of time to make a trucking course. But I mean, once you make it, you have it. And if you screw up, it's kind of a pain. And if you're using course like speed that you record the course at, which I usually do when I'm doing a trucking. Not like max speed or anything like that, because it doesn't really handle turns that well. Stop this. We want to, from recording, field speed like 20. What else do we want? Save this 19 to green bins. this guy to 19 green bins. Yes. Okay, so we have both our trucks on courses. Now we're just gonna have to boogie with the green card. Oh my god, they're already at 30%. It's gonna be interesting, guys. But this is what it's all about. This is where it's fun. This is a lot better than doing tillage, I think. Now the moment of truth is, how much damage do we get on those trailers, and do they completely unload? It's a real question, isn't it? Hopefully everything is great. So I have a pretty decent feeling we're gonna cover a lot of our debts with this harvest, farming, you know, 1,300 acres of some high profit crops. Yeah, 5 miles an hour these guys are raking in the grain. I just want to make sure it's slow enough that they can unload. I think this is a good 5 miles an hour. Manageable. Through some bushes here. much as I can from this guy. It's gonna be a long, long journey back. There's no way I'm gonna have to. Follow this guy out. Through town. Part of this is the lack of they're already full. Is the worst part. Typically when I'm running combine and I have course play on, or the grain cart on course play, I'll do sections and then I'll be able to start and stop. Should be no issue filling up these guys. Place your bets on number of trucks we're pulling out of here. I'm guessing like 15 trucks out of this. Oh, that's cool. Pulls up and then, you guys see that? Filled one trailer up, moved, and then, that's sweet. So the double trailers do work with course, but it's good to know. So they're like exactly on the other side of the field where I am. I have to run around and load these guys again. Actually, while I'm here, I'm gonna have these guys so they don't drive on at 100%. On all the way back. Spot. It's a big hole. Guys, I'm loading. Meanwhile, you can see the field that we're working in. That's one headland down almost. And then we're doing another headland. And then we should get into the business of this field. So hopefully that goes a lot smoother. But I'm glad that course play seems to be working well with the dual trailers. That was kind of a concern of mine. I've never used dual trailers on course play before, so I didn't really know what to expect. Now hopefully they unload both of them at that unload point. I'm assuming it should, right? I guess we shall find out. Anyways, we got one full truck in. ship's standard grain bin capacity is like nothing, really. Let's try to keep this guy empty. Play course is kind of messed up, I think. Such chaos right now. It's another full grain cart. That's why we can only plant so many acres to corn, because we don't have the storage for all that grain. Not only do we not have the storage, but we don't really have the ability to sell it. But now that I'm using course play again, it shouldn't be an issue. I just rent more trucks and trailers and should be able to unload decent amount of grain. I think the most I've ever sold using course play, I was using like 6 trucks on that Salem, North Dakota map in 13, and I think I sold like 5 million liters in an hour. I think that was my biggest like great demand blitz. When you think about it, you're running a trailer that only holds like 43,000 liters or whatever it is, you know, overloaded. It's a lot of trips, a lot of trucks. So course play is gonna go. Hopefully unload my grain and not kill anyone or break the truck. Busy. This thing is still going. Stop and unload. How's this guy doing? I actually had the engine brake on this truck, so that's an easier time braking. Tarps are open. Something really odd about this area of course. It's been a long while since I harvested any crops on this field. Arms are closed, truck. That's awesome. Course play is awesome. Can't believe I actually just said course play is awesome, but it does come in handy. Five-mile-an-hour corn harvest, the slowest corn harvest I've been a part of, but I guess that's pretty realistic. 5.4, 5.6. Comes our truck. Can I just drive through? Tweedledum over here. pretty dang close to ideal six and five. Was truck number three. Take long to fill up this grain cart. A little bit different pace than Sunflower. So what I think I'm gonna do is I'm actually gonna pay off our loans, cause it's like 1.6 million or something like that after this harvest, and take out another loan and buy land. Buy the land that we're leasing right now. Cause my land is costing me about $8,300 a day, which equates to like $250 an acre. If I didn't have to pay that daily, that would help me out a lot. You know, it's hard to build up funds when you're spending that kind of money. You know, 30 days between harvests. $240,000 in that 30 days just rental fees. So at least we have a good system going with our trucking. Once my transportation time goes down from running around these combines on this headland, should run a lot more smoothly. I might even have to rent like an 1100 grain cart or something and bring in the T450, you know? And then we'd be able to. I think I'm gonna do that. I think I'm gonna rent another grain cart, once we get done with this headland. I'll come back to this guy. I'm gonna take care of this bigger guy because he's got more grain. I want him to go a little bit further than if the smaller 990 catches up to him. Empty him out with what I have left. I think corn definitely is like one of the highest profit crops, just because I think our price is at 450 a bushel, plus, you know, we're getting 250 bushel, 270 bushel corn. So it's just the numbers, it's all about the yields. Obviously, we only sell during great demand, so. This field, to buy it's almost 12,000 an acre, I believe. It's like 11.5. You know, big, flat field, pretty easy, course play friendly, next to town. If you need to rent stuff, it's right there at the dealer. Good access to roads. least to the road over here, which I think he should be able to. It's not, should be able to make it. Well, maybe not, it's quite a ways away. I imagine he'd make it over here by this wool shop. Truck number 4 that we're loading right now. Tarp it up. Yep, hits the road. This guy should be getting loaded. Very cool. Works so easy. I'd have to lower the yield of corn down to like maybe like 220 bushel instead of 250. I think back in northern Wisconsin I average like a good yield's like 180. Thank you. this guy up till he's done, and I'll probably end the video here, and so hopefully next time we can get a little bit more efficient system done. So thanks for watching.